According to the State Minister of Public Service, Mary Mugasa, they've continued to register complaints that some district service commissions prefer to hire children or relatives, thus locking out so many Ugandans with the required potential and skills. Some officials have been accused of selling off these jobs.
All a mall and giving price tags to the jobs in the public sector is condemned. I have a feeling that probably because they are nominated by politicians at that level, and the politicians will always choose their campaigners, those who contributed towards their success, and some of them are even taking bribes from them. They buy those jobs.
Mugasa raised the concern today at the office of the Prime Minister while giving accountability of what the Ministry of Public Service has achieved since the 2020 campaigns.
Some districts don't want to advertise jobs. They are so reserved that they want to keep some jobs for their children who are still in school. And those ones who are around, they will always tell them to act. You find someone acting for a long, long time. You ask yourself, why don't you recruit? When you ask them why they don't recruit, they'll give you an excuse that they are not attracting.
To address the challenge, the ministry is working towards developing a new IT system that will help weed out all the fraudulent civil servants, especially those who illegally got on government payroll. The Permanent Secretary of the Office of the Prime Minister, Catherine Bitarakwata Musingwire, gave assurance to the workers that once the country starts commercial oil exploration in 2025, more finances will be channeled to enhancing salaries. She observed the ongoing audit of civil servants by the Auditor General is expected to conclude by June, and they are yet to come up with a report that will name and shame all the ghosts on payroll.
So it was agreed between key stakeholders that we needed to first do an audit, which is going on right now, a validation of all staff who are in post before we can aggregate the total extent of how much wage is needed to close the gap. You'll also note that it was a year in which there was enhancement for salaries of the sciences, both the medical scientists and the non-medical scientists, who included general scientists and teachers as well.
Among the achievements that the ministry has registered in the 2 years of the NRM manifesto includes setting up service centres across the country where the public can access information on government jobs. They've also boasted on increasing salaries of science teachers, university professors, lecturers, among others. Officials noted that starting next financial year, efforts will be channeled at increasing salaries of UPDF, prisons and lower police officers. Report by Jaliet Namoya for the news.